When I think about the urgency of the problem, I think of that old farmer saying, you know, when's the best time to plant a tree 20 years ago? When's the second best time now? That's the urgency of the problem we're facing. We know from the IPCC report that the climate is changing very rapidly. We're looking at what up to a 2-degree increase in temperature within the next 11 and a half years. And that's not that the world ends in 11 and a half years, but it means we have a lot more extreme weather events ahead of us. I put my faith in the farmers who are making the changes. Meanwhile, what our job to do as those of us part of collective organizations, we'll keep working on the politicians. We'll work on those cycles of government and getting them on board. But meanwhile, the house is on fire, so we need more farmers to actually be here putting out the fires and making more resilient systems.
So the journey into regenerative agriculture and the concept of the Regenerative Ag Alliance really came out of the Farming Together program. We'd had enormous uptake from farmers, fishers and foresters to want to collaborate together to improve their state of affairs, basically, to improve profits back at the farm gate. And we ended up with 28,500 farmers connected to that Farming Together program. But when we supported them through expert support and consultants, and when we supported them with grants of money to do their various projects, every one of those projects had a triple bottom line outcome. It ticked the box of being good for the environment, good socially for the community, and had great economic returns for farmers. So it was a natural progression to think, well, where do we take farmers now? Where do we need to go? The whole climate change and drought scenario was really starting to kick in, and I knew that we needed to go to another level. We were beyond sustaining in this country and in the world. We actually needed to take our farmers to the next phase, and the next phase was to repair and to regenerate the land. So because we already had these wonderful farmer groups doing fantastic things, it was just a natural step to take. And it would then make or assist them to be resilient around climate change.
Yeah, so for me, the Alliance is kind of like a really good biodiverse farm, right? As opposed to a monoculture of the same kind of people who all just want to grow the same crop. And why we've got down to, 9 crops in the world, or 66% of our diet. This isn't doing us any good. So the Alliance is a kind of new space where we're saying, well, actually, we need more biodiversity in this space. We need women and men. We need large and small farmers. We need other people who are helping support those farmers. And we need educational institutions. We need all of us coming together to grow a really beautiful and diverse system.
You know, the heart of the community is tremendously important in how we maintain respect for each other, how we move as a community and share information. And I suppose that's where I see the Regenerative Ag Alliance is particularly important, because now we're broadening our community. We've got a group of people that are all looking to try and change. We've all got different ideas, and we're all sharing those ideas now in a way that's building the possibilities for everybody.
And I think that's a beautiful way of looking at how we want our soils to be. You know, if we want our soil to be rich and full of life and full of bugs and critters and conversations and, you know, fun and love, then that's what our community should be. So I think that, you know, if we're able to mirror and understand that for our soil to be diverse, for our soil to be rich, then our communities need to be the same.
I don't think there's any other way to fix it. I think the only way that we can fix the problems at hand is to work collectively and diversely across our many, many systems.